Philippine economic managers are recommending a nationwide shift to COVID alert level 1 to caution the possible effects of the Russia-Ukraine conflict on the economy. Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez says while the war does not have a direct impact on the Philippines, the economy may incur what he calls collateral damage.
It is as if we are hit by a ricocheting bullet. These indirect shocks are likely to be felt through four major channels: the commodity market, the financial market, investments, and the impact on our fiscal health. I would like to emphasize that we do not expect this crisis to last very long. However, there may be some lingering effects. We have seen similar crises in the past, such as the Gulf War in 1990, the Asian financial crisis in 1997, the oil price shock of 2008, and also the first Russia-Ukraine conflict in 2014. And we have weathered all of these crises very well.
The government's economic team is suggesting 14 measures to alleviate the impact of the crisis. Among them, opening all schools for face-to-face classes to increase domestic economy activity and raising the fuel subsidy program for public utility vehicle drivers to 5 billion pesos.
While we cannot prevent the risk from coming from the global perspective, we can strengthen our domestic economy to provide the people with more jobs and opportunities.
The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department raises the alert level in Ukraine to 4. This means the DFA will enforce the mandatory evacuation of Filipinos in Ukraine. They will be assisted by the Philippine Embassy in Poland. Several Filipinos have already returned to Manila, while others have fled to neighboring countries. But many have also refused to leave Ukraine, citing favorable treatment by their employers.
Over a dozen stranded Filipino seafarers witnessed Russia's attacks on Ukraine. This has made them even more anxious to be rescued soon by the Philippine government. Zen Hernandez has this exclusive report.
Oh, dito. Oh. Sir. Ayun ang mga missile.
Papunta doon na. Papunta sa...
Ah, napalitan na naman sila doon, sir. Oh.
Papunta doon.
Papunta doon, oh.
Ayun, ayun, ayun. Ah. Yun na. Filipinos on a ship docked in Odessa, Ukraine, woke up to the sound of missiles and explosions. The target is nearby Mykolaiv, the city after Kherson, which Russian forces claim to have captured. It appears Russia is aiming for Ukraine's biggest port city, Odessa, which is home to a million people. Several ships have been stranded in Odessa's ports after navigation warnings on the risk of mines in the Black Sea.
Yun lang namin naranasan, yung mga ganitong kaganapan. Hindi mo namin nakalain na ganito yung mangyari sa amin. Mentally stressed na kami dito lahat. Pero at least yung opisina namin kumamang dito may pinapagawin.
Cabrera says all 22 on their ship are Filipinos. They are safe and are in constant communication with their principal ship owner. But they cannot help but worry about how long they must stay on board. Just last week, a Bangladeshi crew was killed after a ship was struck by a missile. They were just 300 meters away.
Lahat kami nagtago na lang sa baba. Yung dun sa papunta sa engine room, yun na lang ginawa namin parang ano namin, evacuation place namin.
Pinatatakot po namin yung mga missile ba na nami-misplace sa ibang lugar na baksak. Natitigla namin yung mga putok. Pero medyo malakas-lakas na.
The Department of Foreign Affairs already said it is in contact with ship owners and manning agencies to determine options for extracting the Filipinos from their ships. 21 Filipino seafarers, meanwhile, have been successfully transported to Romania through the combined efforts of the Philippine Consulate in Moldova and Embassy in Hungary. They were evacuated from a Greek vessel that was also stranded in the port of Odessa and are now on board a flight bound for home.
Evacuation is getting to be difficult, especially in the areas where there's conflict, no? So we just ask them to get in touch with our honorary consulate in Kiev or any of our embassies, no, in Warsaw and in Hungary. But if they can go to the border areas, they should at this time.
Another group of Filipino seafarers are expected to arrive in Romania from Ukraine. The DFA previously said it is monitoring 7 ships trapped in Ukraine ports. But international media is reporting that over 100 ships with more than 1,000 mariners are stranded. 3 groups of Filipinos and their dependents from Ukraine also arrived Monday in Manila from Poland. Another group of 2 Filipino adults, a Filipino-Ukrainian child, and his Ukrainian mother is also expected to arrive Monday evening. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.